Hi everyone, it's Cindy here for Lindy's STEM Gang, and today it's going to be all about embossing powders. So as you might know, Lindy's has this great range of embossing powders. Clear ones, really bright and vibrant ones, powders that I like to call color-changing ones, like these. This is a green gold color, or maybe a blue gold color. And today I'd like to show you some quick and fun techniques using these powders. So the first technique that I'd like to show you is just an easy and simple Versamark stamped image and using some magical shakers on them. And I've got myself a piece of paper here, some clearly clear embossing powder and two colors of magical shakers, but I'm going to use them a bit later. And here's a rose stamp by Prima Marketing that I'm going to use. And some of you have been asking me about the glitter residue that stays on top of your images when you stamp them with Versamark, because the glitter is like very almost sticky or static, I think it's called in English. So I've got two products that might help. This is a little bag. I think it's called a Static X or something. And this is, I think it's a bit like baby powder in a little container that you can use with this little brush. And if you brush this on top of your paper or this bag, you can brush it like this. It gets a bit, well, anti-static, so the glitter won't get stuck on it that easily. So I'm going to brush this away a bit. And stamping this image. I'm not using any acrylic blocks or something, but you can do so if you like. Adding the stamp, making sure that it's a clear and nice image, and then just add some clearly clear embossing powder. I'm always using a piece of paper, but there are tray-like products that you can use with embossing powder, but because of the sticky glitter, it's just, for me, it works better to use just a piece of paper. So I'm going to heat set this. So here's the image, all nice. I don't know if you can see it, but all nice. And you should wait for a little bit because it's a bit sticky, or yeah, it's a bit sticky, more glue-like when you don't let it dry for a sec. And when it's all set, you can use shakers or whatever medium you like. Of course, you can use sprays or whatever, but I like to use a little bit of my shaker powder, just adding a little bit. Getting some darker there. And then just add water. I'm going to get myself a baby wipe. And as I'm rubbing off a bit of the color. The VersaMark image started to show. It's almost like a resist kind of technique. So here it is. So for this next technique, I'm going to use a piece of paper, a nice geometrical stencil, and some black modeling paste. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to add a little bit of black modeling paste. And what I usually like to do is using two or maybe even three colors on this, just because of the effect, and the magic just really shows when you're working with different colors or even different kind of embossing powders. So maybe a vibrant color, a angel wings color, or just whatever you like. It's always just a surprise what happens. So I've added a bit of this black paste, and I'm going to get myself some angel wings peacock on top of this. And I'm going to heat set it. But because of the fact that it's paste, it's going to take a while, so I'm going to speed up. So as you can see, it really isn't an even color, but that's just what I like. So besides adding embossing powder and heat setting it to paper using VersaMark or any other ink or modeling paste, you can also use embossing powder to color pieces of metal or pieces of clay or, to be honest, anything you like, as long as you have something that makes the embossing powder stick. I'd like to show you the difference when working on different backgrounds. So I'm using Angel Wings Gold, and I'm adding it to this piece of metal without doing anything other with it. And I'm going to add it on this piece of clay after I've colored it with some Moonshadow Mist. So these are like really special colors, and I really, really love them. And I'm just adding a bit on top of the face, the little cute moon face. And because it's still wet, I'm going to use my other VersaMark ink pad. And I'm adding some on top of the metal. So because of the use of different backgrounds, you can see that it really finishes in different colors. So I really like to use the angel wings colors on different backgrounds just because of this. So the last one is just the easy one and fast one. I'm adding some VersaMark on top of this piece of clay, and I'm going to add a dark colored embossing powder, Midnight Sapphire, just to give it a really, really gorgeous blue color. Then you can see it has this really, really, really gorgeous blue color. And it's almost magical. So here you have some quick and easy techniques to use with your favorite Lindy's embossing powders. Thank you for watching, and have a great day.